Welcome back, everybody. This is Zach with New England Sports Talk, and today we are recapping the 2019 draft profile for Coby White, the 6'5" guard, about 185 pounds or so, freshman point guard out of North Carolina. This dude is a stud. We're going to go over it. This is actually our second point guard video of today. I went over Darius Garland. If you haven't already seen that video, go check it out. I released that this morning. I was re-listening to it, I guess, after I posted it, and I might sound a little monotone. I got up at like 5 this morning and was recording it, so I apologize for that. I didn't realize how monotone I sounded until I replayed it and it already posted. So if you guys want to check that out, please go ahead and check that out. Darius Garland is a stud, but today we're going to talk about Coby White. So this is the Coby White video. Like I said, he's a freshman guard out of North Carolina. He's got the whole package. This is a dude who is going to have a great career in the NBA, I believe. And we're going to just start off the video with going over his strengths as usual. So just like kind of similar with the Ja Morant video I did and the Darius Garland video I did as well too, Coby White is another one of those guys who just has elite quickness. He's probably one of the quickest guys in this draft. No doubt, actually. There's no doubt that he's one of the quickest guys in the draft. And that really elevates his game so much more when he's so quick and he's got that first step that can just kill you at an instance, honestly. Because of his quick step, because of his quickness he has, he's extremely aggressive when he scores the basket. He can really score anywhere. He can score from the three-point line. He can get to the basket. He can run the pick and roll. He can hit the mid-range, that kind of thing, and he's fantastic at it. Also, he's really good with that quickness. He's really good at getting fouls as well. James Harden is one of the players in the league right now who's so quick and gets so many foul calls on him. Jimmy Butler's another one, for example. Giannis, obviously, he's huge. Joel Embiid is huge. But those are some of the top free throw shooters in the league this year, and the reason why they're so good is because of their quick step, their quickness that they have on the court. I'm not saying that Coby White's going to be one of those guys, but I'm just saying it's a trend that you have to have when you're scouting prospects coming into the 2019 draft and scouting for potential players to invest in such a high draft pick on them. You want to make sure that they get some of the fundamentals down, and that's stuff that you can't teach. Drawing fouls typically is something you can't really teach. And he comes in and he's got just an instinct for it, and it's awesome seeing that. Now, not only can he draw the fouls, but he's also a fantastic free throw shooter as well. It just seems like the last maybe 10 years or so watching the NBA, I've been watching the NBA for so long now, that there's been such a drop off on consistent good free throw shooters. Like Steph Curry's great, Chris Paul's great, Dame Lillard's great, but like maybe somebody like Russell Westbrook or even LeBron James, Lonzo Ball, like some of these guys that I've had to throw Lonzo Ball in there, but some of these guys, they are franchise players. I guess I should have kept Lonzo Ball out of that, but they're franchise players and they're having a tough time shooting free throws. It's just odd. It's just really odd to me. It seems really strange as well. But Coby White is somebody, if you're going to invest in an early first round pick on him, he's got the capability of hitting the free throws and getting that taken care of as well. Swinging over to the defensive side as well, not only does he have quick feet like we talked about, but he's got active hands as well too. He's really good at staying with his defender, staying on defense, and staying in front of him, that kind of thing. But having active hands as well, being able to play the passing lane, and pickpocket players whenever they try to cross him or whatever the case may be. Now, some of the growth areas for him, he does have sort of a low release on his shot. You've got a question with him, can he shoot over taller defenders consistently? Maybe like if he's playing against a Klay Thompson, Jimmy Butler, some of those guys, Paul George, whatever, whoever's going to be guarding him on defense, can he get his shot over on taller defenders? And that's going to be interesting. Does he need to bring it up, or is he going to get his release because it is lower? Can he get it off quicker? And maybe that's a way that he can kind of adapt it, either shooting quicker or shooting higher. That might be something that he needs to grow into, but we'll see. Also, just passing more accurately, throwing the right pass at the right time. There has been some problems with that in last year's season when he played with North Carolina. Can he throw the fundamental pass? Can he get it on the player at where it needs to be? And also not throw so many turnovers as well too. The third thing for him was the turnovers as well too. He almost had 3 a game that he averaged on turnovers on offense. So can he lower that down? I think it comes down to just throwing the right pass, and I think that's going to happen whenever he has a better understanding of the offense he's going to be running in the NBA, whatever team he decides to go to, or he gets elected to, rather. Let's talk about some of his hardware he has, and he's got a lot of it. Talking about his high school days first, 2017, he was named the North Carolina Player of the Year. 2018, he was named in high school again, North Carolina Mr. Basketball. So he's got some good hardware, an elite company, and some of those guys that were in the running for that in North Carolina as well. And then also last year, because he only played 1 year in North Carolina, right? So he was elected to the All-Tournament second team, All-Conference second team, and then also the All-Rookie team as well, too. So fantastic selections, team selections that he has. And he's going to, that's probably going to carry over. I wouldn't be surprised if he's in on an All-Rookie team next year as well. Maybe first team, but maybe second team as well. We'll see. He's got the potential to be that, though, and we're going to go over his comparison and kind of explain what his game is going to bring to your team if you get him. Now, his 2018-2019 stats, I'll post that as well, too. Points per game, he had 16 points per game. That's very similar to Darius Garland, like I mentioned, and I know I'm giving him kind of some comparisons here with Darius Garland because I just did that one, and they are pretty similar, actually. They each have 3 rebounds a game. Coby White did have 4 assists a game, and then he shot 42% from the field. Obviously, Darius Garland only played 5 games. Coby White played a full season. So this is a pretty accurate perception of what he's going to bring to your team. He's going to throw the right pass when he needs to once he gets that taken care of and he gets a better comfort, I guess, in his offense and that kind of thing. He's going to be active on defense and getting rebounds. He's going to score efficiently. He's going to score pretty much at will, it seems like, in most cases. Now, his comparison for him coming into the league. Now, the floor that I have for him, again, we never project any of these guys to be busts at all or anything like that. That's not the reason for this channel at all. We want to be fair and accurate and as much as we can be. So for the floor that I gave him on his comparison, I put him with maybe an OJ Mayo or Jamal Murray. Those guys are fantastic combo guards that were in the league. Obviously, Jamal Murray played with Denver this year. They had a pretty good run against the Portland Trail Blazers and then also the San Antonio Spurs in the first round as well. Jamal Murray played lights out pretty much the entire postseason, really the entire season as well too. He's a fantastic guard. He's going to be in here for a while, and he's very consistent. I think that's a role that Coby White could have at the least. Now, the ceiling, I know that this one might seem kind of weird, but I think his ceiling might be Gilbert Arenas. Now, I know Gilbert Arenas hasn't been in the league for a long time, but his elite scoring ability and his aggressive mindset when he's coming into score, you know, that I think that's exactly what he's going to do. I think he's going to adapt into that very well. I don't know if he's going to be a Gilbert Arenas. That's up to him, right? So he's got to be able to prove it. He's got to put in the works. But given his body type, given his mentality on defense, his mentality on offense as well, he's all around. He could be a star one of these days. And if it is, he's probably going to most similarly link up with maybe a Gilbert Arenas. But that was it, guys. For Coby White, let me know in the comments below what you think about him. If your team drafts him, you're going to be ecstatic. I know I say that just about on every single video, but the dude is a stud. He really is. And I know I'm not just saying that either. This is going to be a good guy in the league for a long time to come. As always, guys, if you haven't already, make sure you hit the subscribe button, hit that bell notification icon, and leave a comment. What player do you want to see me go over next? I was thinking about, since I did a combo, like a 2 point guards today, I might do like a Bol Bol and a Taco Fall, like the two big centers that are coming into the league next year. Maybe Hayes from Texas as well too. Let me know what you guys want to see. Do you guys want to see some point guards? Do you want to see some small forwards, shooting guards, power forwards, centers as well too? What do you guys want to see? I've got a lot of videos out now at this point, but I want to keep making sure that I'm being consistent with this. So let me know what you guys think and let me know what you guys want to see, and I'll make sure I get it out for you guys. As always, remember to like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one. Thanks, guys.